Listen and you'll hear the heartbeat of a universe teeming with force. See all the forms and the faces of nature taking its course. And feel all the wonderful motion flowing through things far and near. Nature will share her secrets when we are ready to hear. Energy, you are profound. You make the world go round and round. You make the world go
John, and on behalf of Exxon, I'd like to welcome you here to the universe of energy today.
The universe we know is one of dynamic forces, its heartbeat sending a constant flow of energy coursing through the vastness. This energy is never destroyed, nor is new energy created. But energy is perceived in different forms. Within the atoms of all matter, on a level most infinitesimal yet most powerful, is nuclear energy. Binding atoms into molecules and crystals and stored in the cells of all living things is chemical energy. In the sudden flow of electrons, there is electrical energy. In the world around us, there is constant motion, and in this motion, there is mechanical energy. Unleashed in the motion of molecules themselves is heat energy. Finally, washing over the earth in an all-pervasive, never-ending flood is light energy. We long observed with fascination the interplay of these elemental forms of energy, noting that certain forms often changed into others. Then, through the genius of the human mind, came the realization that energy could be harnessed and made to work for us. Energy locked in Earth's vast forests was put to use. Fire became both friend and tool. Thank you. The unbridled winds were captured. The flows of mighty rivers were tapped. For centuries, we depended on these three resources alone. Then, only a little while ago, we learned to use the energy locked in fossil fuels. In coal. In oil and natural gas. The energy from these fuels has dramatically advanced civilization. Sooner or later, present resources will not be sufficient for the world's energy needs. Only by understanding energy in its various forms, the universe of energy, can we build a transition to a better tomorrow.
Listen and you'll hear the heartbeat of a universe teeming with force. See all the forms and the faces of nature taking its course. And feel all the wonderful motion flowing through things far and near. Nature will share her secrets when we are ready to hear. Energy, these are a few of your faces, glowing in timeless places, bringing our lives new graces. Energy, there is no living without you. We must keep learning about you. Now is the time to find how to. Energy, you are profound. You make the world go round and round. You make the world go round. You make the world go round. You make the world go round.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. And welcome to the Universe of Energy. In just a few moments, the automatic theater doors will be opening towards you. Until then, please stand clear.
Thank you. source of energy in all fossil fuels. Its radiance, forming upon the seas of Earth, gives rise to the first stirrings of life. Myriads of creatures evolve, feeding upon plants and each other, capturing the sun's energy for themselves. As death comes, there begins a ceaseless, silent snowfall of organic matter, drifting downward with other sediments, accumulating layer after layer upon the ocean floor. Finally, time, heat, and pressure transform the sediments into shale, entombing countless remains of marine life. Eons of time pass. The shale is buried still more deeply, and its organic material transformed into oil and gas. These fossil fuels then begin to creep into surrounding layers of more permeable rock. The endless wrenching of the Earth's crust causes these strata to be folded and broken, sometimes trapping oil and gas in the porous rock. On the surface, vast new forms of plant life take root. As sunlight floods the lush primeval forests, every plant and tree captures a bit of this energy. In the ageless cycle of life, these living things do wither and fall. In marshy areas, the decaying limbs and leaves form a spongy mass of peat. For near endless millennia, the process continues until marshes and swamps finally disappear, sinking deeper under cover of mud and sand. Once again, heat, pressure, and time work a remarkable transformation. The peat turns into coal. The formation of fossil fuels occurred over a span of millions upon millions of years. Much of the Earth's present supply was deposited during the primeval era when great reptiles roamed the land. Come with us now and experience a few moments from that dark and mysterious past.
20th century. As you have seen, the Mesozoic era was a time of violent geologic activity. For 100 billion years, the Earth was torn by natural forces. Vast amounts of organic material were trapped deep inside the Earth, and over millions of years, it was transformed into the fossil fuels we use today. These monitors behind the operating console show current and future energy resources around the world. Among them are fossil fuels, nuclear, hydroelectric, geothermal, wind, and solar. Your traveling theater vehicles are partially powered by the sun. The solar cells on this building's roof help recharge batteries in the vehicles when they're stopped. Computers guide the vehicles along a wire that is just an eighth of an inch thick. The maps highlight locations that we'll visit during the next part of our journey. We'll travel from the Alaska frontier to the North Sea to the Mideast. We'll explore potential energy sources for the near and distant future. Now that you've experienced the dramatic forces that created today's fossil fuels, let's continue our journey through the universe of energy. Coming from sun-parched regions of the globe like the Middle East. Stretching across the hot desert sands, massive pipelines carry petroleum to the edge of the sea. It is a supply that is not inexhaustible, however. But the global demand for energy, all kinds of energy, continues to increase. Must depend on the uncertainties of imported oil until the big breakthroughs finally happen. But the world can't simply park its cars or turn off its lights until that day. We must continue to conserve and extend today's energy sources and develop a broad mix of alternatives for the future. Already, current supplies are being stretched through the use of heat-sensing monitors and other new systems which help increase energy conservation. At the same time, special oil recovery techniques are helping to bring older fields back to life. Even so, the world is continuing to diminish today's known reserves. The energy search must go on to help us bridge to the future. Out in space, eye-in-the-sky satellites scan the face of the Earth, helping to find new oil and gas deposits. On land, seismic crews record echoes to pinpoint new locations. The best hopes for finding major new supplies often lie in some of the world's most remote environments. Sometimes miles below the ocean floor. On land, these great drilling platforms would dwarf all of the world's tallest buildings.
I just got a quick two on the chopper.
In the ocean, they function as complex, massive island communities, surviving in often treacherous waters like the chilling, windswept North Sea.
You gotta call it. Take it up there, right? 1500 hours.
is now pushing still deeper. Here, a new breed of remote-controlled Ocean 4 units can bring up oil and gas from once inaccessible regions. The job of transporting fossil fuels has its own challenges. Near the top of the world, at Prudhoe Bay, Alaska, is the largest oil field in North America. The Trans-Alaska Pipeline begins here. A $9 billion energy highway stretching 800 miles over and under the rugged frontier. Technologies are being developed that one day may economically provide energy in the form of synthetic gas and liquids. Synthetic oil is already being produced from these vast Canadian tar sands. Oil shale, the rock that burns. Located in the western United States, it is one of the greatest syn fuel resources of all. Mined, crushed, and heated, it could yield billions of barrels of liquid energy. Smaller quantities of syn fuel may be derived from a pesky river-clogging weed, the water hyacinth, along with grains, recycled wastes, and other biomass resources. The most abundant of fossil fuels. It is mined primarily to generate electricity, a growing demand for the years ahead. And one day, it too may yield large amounts of synthetic oil and gas. United States. That's energy equivalent to more than twice the Middle East oil supply. Sometimes coal is hidden deep in the earth. Other times it lies near the surface. Here the overlying soil and rock must first be removed to reveal the coal deposits below. Then it is replaced and replanted, a massive reclamation project to help bring the land back to life. Another environmental demand on coal is also important. While some is clean burning, some requires precipitators, wet scrubbers, and other new technologies, costly but necessary systems designed to reduce emissions to harmless water vapor. Other sources, even small ones, may also help meet tomorrow's growing demand for electricity. From the Earth's great underground cauldron, the power of geothermal steam. The wind, age-old power to drive the windmills of tomorrow. Source of electricity. Chicago, for example, gets more than half its electric power from nuclear plants.
and around the world, France, Germany, Japan, and many other nations are continuing to develop nuclear power as part of their energy bridge to the future. Some countries are also moving ahead with a new process, the breeder reactor, which actually creates more fuel as it operates. Within 2 decades, nuclear energy will probably contribute about a fourth of the world's electricity. Unlimited electric power for tomorrow. Is it a fantasy? A pipe dream? Scientists at Princeton and other research centers don't think so, as they inch toward the process of the stars, nuclear fusion. The challenge? To fuse hydrogen isotopes at temperatures exceeding 180 million degrees. The potential exists for a real breakthrough to one day harness this inexhaustible new energy source. From the sun itself comes another potential for the future, solar energy. Solar heating and cooling are already in limited use. By the next century, research will hopefully lower the cost of converting sunlight directly into electricity. Epcot's Energy Pavilion provides a showcase for today's solar technology. More than 80,000 photovoltaic cells have been installed on the roof. When exposed to sunlight, they generate electric current to help power your traveling theater cars. So, in a sense, you've been riding on sunshine throughout our show. In our ever-changing world, the road to tomorrow's energy is indeed long, complex, and challenging. It demands the development and wise use of today's energy resources. It calls for practical and affordable new sources for tomorrow. And it will require the combined efforts of science, industry, government, and the public. Then we will indeed bridge to the future, to a world which one day may harness the entire universe of energy.
10, 9, 8, ignition sequence start, engines are on.
information on energy resources, we invite you to visit Exxon's Energy Exchange, located in Communicore East. At this time, gather all your personal belongings and exit through the open doors behind you. Thank you.
Nuclear power generates 12% of all the electricity in the United States. Touch the region where you live to find out about nuclear power in your area. Nuclear power generates 15% of the electricity used in the Southeast.